Did you know that using the wrong machine technique for a hole in Abaqus could completely throw off your simulation results? There are three key methods, and by the end of this video, you'll not only know all three, but will rank them from worst to best based on accuracy, efficiency, and ease of use. And trust me, the number one method might change your simulations forever. Before explaining the first method, we need a part to work with. So from part module, we go to the create part, 2D planner, deformable, and shell. Continue, we need a rectangular plate with a hole in it. So I create a rectangle just like this. Then I add the dimensions. Let's have 25 here. And for this one, let's have 50. Then auto fit view. I zoom out a little. Then from here, we can create a circle. As you see here, we have a plus. When I create the part, besides the center of the circle, we have an additional spot here. So this one must be on one of the vertical directions here, 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 or here. If it's somewhere in the middle, just like here, it's going to mess with your meshing. So you cannot mesh the one quarter of a circle. So it's vital to create it here. Okay. Now we have to make sure it's in the middle. So this is 25, that's okay. I press on escape. This one is also 25, escape. But this one should be 12.5. Now we make sure it's in the center. Scroll button once more, and now we have this part. As we only focus on meshing techniques here, I don't add any properties or any section assignments. I go straight to the assembly to assemble my model here. Okay, now let's go to the mesh. Okay, now we have to click on part in order to mesh this one. The first technique is to change the meshing algorithm. As a result, we click on assign mesh control, and from quad dominated, we change it to quad. First, I'm going to show you what's quad dominated. When I mesh this one with the quad dominated, we see we have some triangular meshing adjacent to the hole, which is not good. Then by changing the mesh control to the quad and medial axis, and clicking on OK. So as we meshed it, we need to delete the meshes. Here, I mesh it once more, and you see we have a better meshing. To have better and more accurate one, we can also sit the edges. For instance, on this one, we can put this value on by number and value of 8, for instance. Then you can reduce the approximate global size to somewhere around, for instance, 3. And let's create the mesh. And as you see, we have a better and more accurate meshing scheme here. The second technique requires modification of the part. So we navigate to partition face sketch. This one, we create a circle. We need to create a circle bigger than the inner one. So we have an inner circle, an outer circle. Then by creating the lines, we want to create lines just like this. And a scroll button, then we can create lines right here. Then scroll button again. Now we have these lines and one outer circle. Now it's time to seed the edges. Okay, from here, we select everything on this one, and by clicking on scroll button, we can have a value of 6 here, for instance. Then we can mesh. As you see, we have a good mesh here, and the element size are decreasing toward the hole, and the meshing is good. This technique also needs partitioning the model, but in a different way. So we go to the partition face sketch once more, and let's create lines here, something like this. then we can create one line just right here. Let's make sure the distance is the same. So from here to here, it's like 1525. This is 1525, which is good. Let's create more lines. One vertical one, one horizontal one, then I create one diagonal here, and the other one just right here. After the partitioning is completed, these lines are going to be removed automatically. And as you see here, we have a couple of lines and we need to bias them. So from here, we go to the seed edges and we select all edges by holding shift. We can select them. Then the scroll button and the basic, the method is bias single, and let's have the number of elements of 10 here with the bias ratio of 5. And we need to flip the edges that are not facing toward the hole. So from here, flip bias, we select this one, hold shift, select this one, this one, this one, and done. As you see, all of them are facing toward the hole. Click OK. Now let's see, how's the mesh? And as you see, it's not a bad mesh. It's like a spider web. We can also bias these edges in order to have a better transition, because we have big elements here and they reduce in the size here. So feel free to bias these edges. Now it's time to rank the models. But before we jump into this, I have a small favor to ask. If you find this content helpful, consider subscribing. It's completely free for you, but it gives me the motivation to create more detailed Abaqus tutorials like this one. Now let's get into it. For this purpose, I applied a simple loading condition on all of the models, the same one. So I create a pressure with 100 megapascal magnitude on one side and fix the other side with this boundary condition, just like this one, and ran the jobs. And it's time to compare them. But before we go to the comparison, let's see how many elements does each model have. For this one, we need to go to query information and mesh and done. If we extend this one, we see that total number of nodes is 128 and total number of elements is 102. And the types are CPS4R. Now let's do it for model number 2. The same thing, mesh and done. We have more numbers of elements. And for the model 3, we do the same thing. And we can have a good comparison. This is the first model. I want to do it for this one as well, in order to have a better comparison. Mesh and done. Now let's go to the job and see the results. So let's see the results of this one. We have 210 megapascal. We can see other jobs here, for instance job 1 and job 2 here. Also we can have job 3. Let's see the results, and there's a huge difference between these models. Let's go to the viewport and create. This is the job 3. We can go to other jobs, viewport, create, job 1, viewport, and create, and the job 0, viewport, and create. We have all these jobs opened, and if we go to the viewport and tile horizontally, we can have them here. If I activate this one, and if we go to the viewport, and here we can link the viewports. Now if we go to the viewport and viewport annotation option and the legend, we can set the font like 8, and it can be applied to all of them. So yeah, okay, we do have this one. This is the first model we have, the viewport 4. And this model is not accurate at all. As you see, when we reduce the mesh size, we have a convergence to here 317 and here is 325. It means that this mesh is not accurate at all. And here this one is not any different with the other one. But between these two, we have a slight change here, 317 megapascal. And this one is 325 megapascal, which is not very different, but still shows a higher accuracy in this one. But let's see if we look at the total mesh numbers. This is for the second one, viewport 2. We do have total number of nodes 296 and 284 for this one. And we do have 260 elements on this one, but 256 on this one. But we have to consider the fact that this one here is not refined enough compared to this one. So is the number of nodes and elements are not accurate enough here. If you look at the contour of the right hand side, we don't have too many distorted elements, but here we have a couple of elements like elongated on this part around the hole, which can reduces the accuracy. And also this model is pretty hard to create because we have to create so many lines, we have to bias edges, and it takes more time. But this one is more efficient and it's easy to create and it reveals a very good accuracy. So if we want to rank the models based on accuracy, efficiency, and ease of use, rank 3 would be the mesh algorithm model because of not being accurate enough and having big elements around the hole. Second rank goes to structured partitioning model. Even though being very accurate, the modeling is pretty hard. Having large and elongated elements around the hole would be a downside of this model. And the first one would be local refinement machine technique for sure, because of being very accurate, easy to model, and have refined elements near the hole. That's it. If you enjoyed this video, smash the subscribe button. And if you want to learn XFEM crack growth, click on the video on screen before it ends. See you in the next one.